Students who want to progress to a university in South Africa need to hold a senior certificate with matriculation endorsement. However, University South Africa will grant exemption certificates to holders of Cambridge International AS and A levels, granted that they meet specific requirements and certain subject group requirements. Basically, if you're choosing to follow the Cambridge examinations instead of the formal secondary school route in the South African schooling system, you need to qualify for a certificate of complete or conditional exemption to apply to a South African university according to USAF's requirements. You can't just pitch at a university with like your three IG subjects and say, please accept me. That's not entirely how it works. And in this video, I'm going to detail exactly what the three options are for homeschoolers specifically to be able to qualify for that certificate of exemption to be able to apply to a South African university with your Cambridge marks. So as I said, for homeschoolers, there are three options. The first option is two A-levels and three IG levels. The second option is three A-levels and one IG. And the third option is four AS levels and one IG. So the way the system works is you can't just pick like any two AS and any three IG subjects. USAF has grouped the Cambridge subjects into five groups. So let me cover what exactly those groups are, what subjects are in those groups, and how you need to pick and choose to meet the requirements for USAF certificate of exemption. So the first group is just the first language. So this would be English language and literature, or any other recognized first language. If you're curious about what exactly those other recognized languages are, I'll leave a link in the description to the official documentation that USAF made, the PDF file that you can go check out. They detail everything over there, and I'd recommend you go check that out if you're curious. Group two is a second language. This includes Afrikaans, Arabic, Chinese, etc. The list actually goes longer down than what the screenshot actually has in it because I couldn't fit the massive list into the screenshot. Again, I'll leave a link in the description so you can go check it out yourself. Group three is a third language. This is a language that isn't offered as a group two requirement, or biology, chemistry, combined science, coordinated science, mathematics, physics, or physical science. Group four includes art and design, biology, chemistry, economics, environmental management, geography, history, mathematics, music, physics, and physical science. Group five includes accounting, business, computer studies, computing, computer science, design and technology, divinity, further mathematics, information technology, and religious studies. There's also a sixth group of subjects that aren't grouped into the other five but are still recognized by USAF. These include literature, applied information and communication technology, drama, travel and tourism, and information communication technology. Okay, so with all that in mind, here are the details for what these groups mean for each of the three options that I mentioned before. Okay, so as I said, option one is two A-levels and three IG levels. So that means five subjects, with the minimum grade for the A-levels being an E, which is 40-49%, and the minimum grade for your three IGCSE subjects would be a C, which is 60-69%. For this option, you need at least one subject from each of group 1, 2, and 3 on A or IG level, and the fourth and fifth subjects can be from any of the groups on either IG or A level. So as you can see, to be able to meet the requirements, you kind of need to mix and match a bit, and make sure you meet the specific requirements when it comes to picking subjects from specific groups, whilst also still remaining within the three A-levels and two IG levels boundary. Of course, you can do more than three A-levels and more than two IG levels, but that just won't matter when it comes to meeting the requirements for your official certificate of exemption. And I personally would suggest that you don't stretch yourself too thin. A-levels specifically are quite intense, and I'd suggest rather not doing more than three A-levels if you go for this first option. Of course, you can do whatever you like, but that's just my advice. For option two, again, that's three A-levels and one IG level. This is four subjects, with the minimum grade for your A being an E, which is 40-49%, and the minimum grade for the IGCSE subjects being a C, which is 60-69%. As for the groups, it's the same thing. You need at least one subject from each of group one, two, and group three on either A or IG level, and then your fourth subject can be from any of the groups on either IG or A level. For this option, there are already three A levels. I'd suggest you don't do more than three A-levels, as with option one. For option three, you'd be doing four AS levels and one IG level. This is the most popular out of the three options. Students tend to go for this option just because AS levels are at a matric level. You're skipping all of the A-level stuff, which is on a grade 13 level anyway, and you stick to the AS level stuff, which is just matric. And that way, if you're in grade 12 and you're wanting to qualify for a certificate of exemption, you're only doing matric level stuff. and you're not making it too hard for yourself. So option three would be 5 subjects, with the minimum grade for your AS levels being a D, which is 50 to 59%, and for your IG levels, the minimum grade is a C, which is 60 to 69%. For this option, it's a bit different than the other two. You need to pick one subject from either group 1 or 2, and another 2 subjects from 2 of group 3, 4, and 5. English first language is a requirement when it comes to this third option. 2 languages must be offered to qualify for exemption, so that would mean that you need to do English first language, which gives you a slot for a second language that you can choose to do from any of the long list of languages that Cambridge offers. If you already have a second language in mind that you want to do, most students go for Afrikaans as a second language, but you can just, again, check out the description. I have the official documentation there. You can go check whether the language that you want to do is recognized by USAF and will help you qualify for that exemption. So in summary, you must have a recognized first language from group 1. You must have a second or additional language from group 2. You must have a group 3 subject. If offering a subject from the 5th group, you must have IG math with at least a C grade. Within these requirements, for any A levels that you pick, the minimum grade is an E, which is 40 to 49%. The minimum grade for AS levels is a D, which is 50 to 59%. And the minimum grade for IG levels is a C, which is 60 to 69%. So that summarizes the requirements that USAF has that you need to hand to them to be able to qualify for a certificate of exemption to be able to apply to a South African university. Generally, this is a pretty straightforward process. You just need to make sure that the subjects that you're choosing will firstly be relevant for what you want to study, if you know what you want to study in university, and secondly, are recognized by USAF and meet the requirements as a combined group of subjects to be able to qualify for that exemption. Again, I'd really suggest you go check out the documentation yourself. As I said, there's a link in the description that you can click on just to make sure for yourself that what you're doing will allow you to qualify for that certificate of exemption. Something very important that has changed within the recent years is that the A-levels are no longer modular, they are now linear. So if you've been on the Cambridge scene for a while now, you'll know that A-levels used to be modular, meaning that in the past you would write your AS-level examinations and then carry those results forward into your further A-level examinations to complete your final A-level qualification. Now, however, A-levels are linear, meaning that your A-level examinations include the AS-level content, irrespective of whether you have written your AS-levels before. In other words, if you have written your AS-level examinations, if you want to do your A-levels, your previous AS-level results are irrelevant, and to complete your A-levels, you'll have to cover the AS-level material again, as well as the A-level material for your A-level examinations. Because of this, students who are aiming to complete their A-levels have obviously begun to skip their AS levels entirely, and are rather taking 2 years to complete their A-levels instead of 1 year for AS and 1 year for A, as they would do previously. That's just something that's quite important that you should note if you're wanting to do your A-level qualification. Something to note, and that's helpful to clear up, is that a USAF exemption isn't a matric certificate. You will receive your certificates for each of the examinations that you took, and that is your matric certificate. You get that from Cambridge, not USAF. However, those official Cambridge certificates will be considered by USAF, and if eligible, will grant you a certificate of exemption, which you can then use to apply to South African universities. Having an exemption does not mean that you will be accepted to a South African university. Again, your exemption can only be used to apply to university. The university will then consider your exemption and make their decision based on if your results meet their requirements, just like any other student's normal South African matric certificate. All right, now that you know that, if you're wondering how to register for an exam in South Africa, specifically the Cape Town area, I'm going to be making another video that I will link up on the screen that you can go check out. In that video, I will cover specific institutions that allow you to write the Cambridge examinations through them as a private candidate, and what exactly you can expect when it comes to registering and then actually walking into the hall and writing the exam. The rules, regulations, what you can and can't do, just to put your mind at ease if you're a bit stressed about writing your first exam. That's the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, leave a like, that helps me out a ton. If you have any questions at all, please do leave that in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video. Good luck on your studying journey.